Welcome to the STABcast, a podcast dedicated to Star Wars Legion.
The Republic ground troops have been routed, Emir.
What was that?
I calculate the remaining clones are attempting a desperate final offensive. Their chances of success against us are 742-1.
You had better be right.
I am a droid. I am always right.
Welcome, cadets and commanders, to the STABcast, the Sunsphere Tactical Attack Brigade Star Wars Legion podcast. I'm Tim, the Punching Bag Hannon, with Ben, Fists of Fury Fowler, Ryan, Right Hook Zalowski, and Will, Uppercut Heim. How's everybody doing, guys?
I'm doing great on my lofty throne.
Tim, oh, Tim's had a week.
It's been
Tim
a week.
Tim has had a week.
I've had a lot of Legion.
I'll uppercut you anytime, Tim.
I know you will, bud. Thank you.
Oh, I have so many fists now.
Wait.
It's just this week on STABcast, battle reports, some upcoming online events, some new year predictions of how our success may be in those events, and much, much more.
It's safe.
Reports of battle.
Reports of battle, many reports of battle. Tim, we had a game set up and then things got thrown off. It was very sad. So Tim decided to play everyone else on the Discord server but me. So I had to go cross continental.
That's why they call him Two Wheels, right? He gets ridden around the Discord.
Oh, God.
That's not true. Someone did ask Tim, hey, are you available to play? Tim was like, when are you available? He's like, any day next week. Tim's like, I'm busy.
That was Florf. No, that was Florf.
That was Florf the dwarf.
Oh, yeah, so you're just terrified. All right, got it.
Yeah, he gave me a date. I was like, oh, okay, I can't do that. What's another date you have available? He's like, anytime next week. I was like, nope, busy all that week. Nope, forget it.
So, be gone.
So Tim's terrified of rebel players. We got it.
Yep.
Speaking of terrifying rebel players, I went across the continent to our good friend Cole Key. We found a time where
different continent.
Yeah. That is true. That is true. some would have it to be believed that it's a different continent. We found time where it was really late for him and really early for me, but we were both cognitive enough to be able to play a game of Legion. And so we did. It's always fun to play with longtime listeners, and me and Colkey have bantered back and forth quite a bit. And I was not sure what he was going to bring. And after talking to him, he wasn't sure what I was going to bring either, because we tend to bring weird rebel janky lists. So I brought to the table Jyn Erso, Sabine Wren, three rebel troopers, one of which had a medical droid, Clan Wren, a rebel commando strike team, and a T-47 airspeeder. I was trying to find a way to play Sabine, Clan Wren in a airspeeder altogether, because that sounded really fun. And this is how I kind of made it work. I was not entirely prepared for what followed. It was just a generic rebel officer with Op Luke, R2-D2, four rebel troopers with the DLT range 4 crit weapon on them, three strike teams, and an X-34 land speeder with next to nothing on it, just as a Luke/R2-D2 delivery mobile.
Gross.
Yep. It sure was. And
you don't need to deliver
just
that.
Just for you, Tim.
No, thank you.
I want to say it was a 16-point bid.
Oh. Ooh. You just continue to insult me.
We start playing. We hit our turn zero. I'm obviously the red player. We played on a battle lines map that got cut, sadly, from the round robin. I hope it makes its way into single limbs. But it was Navarro, the Mandalorian Season 1 planet. And it was actually a pretty cool little map of this little kind of old westy style, kind of one main dividing street with buildings on each side, kind of shootout. It had the cool archway that we get to see quite a bit in the show. And we set up, we play Sabotage, the Moisture Evaporators, Fortified Positions, and good old battle lines.
Nice. Okay.
I have some pretty solid defensive deployments for my VAPs. I think I got a little bit stronger of a position with VAPs. One remark I will kind of make on the map is we were both lucky. We both felt really good about fortified positions because it had a lot of light cover, but not a lot of heavy. And it felt pretty good
once we put fortified down on battle lines.
Okay, that makes sense.
Normally it feels crowded, so I guess it's good that
We'll talk about this later, but Ben and I had a map where we fortified was a mistake. But yeah, that's for later.
It was perfectly fine. Fine for me. It's
for later.
Yeah. So on one side of my map, on one of my VAPs, I put... I actually put both my VAPs on one side with Jin, two sets of Rebel Troopers, and Jin was my last deployment, and she just deployed out of line of sight right on an evaporator. So that always feels good when you get to pull that off to start fixing that thing right away. I put two Rebel Troopers kind of in the middle to where they were at the edge of Jin's leadership bubble, but they could go wherever the help was particularly needed. Mm. And then I gave my strike team, Clan Ren and Sabine, the offensive flank to go, you know, jump over buildings and harass his VAPs. He was in activation up on me, so he got last place, and he had this really great access to the middle of the table, the middle of this kind of town square, where he blobbed up his infantry, and then he had a really great hill that he wasn't using a ton of, and he kind of had to make a decision, since he's just got the rebel officer, where he wants to kind of bulk his army up. But what he ended up using that hill for is he put his land speeder on it with Luke inside. And both of my points were very close to each other and kind of minorly defended with Jin and some rebel troopers and a T-47. But obviously the T-47's not going to hang out very long. It's not a particularly defensive piece.
Depends.
Yeah, I mean, depends on the list, honestly.
So my plan for it was if I can get a good shot with Luke with my T-47 to soften it up, I'm going to go for it. I'm going to zoom in there. But I really, what I really wanted to do is I wanted him to commit his Luke away from his army, which he inevitably did. And then I wanted to snake around, because the way the buildings were set up is I could do a turn one, hit Luke or the land speeder with my T-47, and then turn two, hit come where his army is going to take its fortified position and come behind it. And I really wanted to knock out that rebel commander, A, to deny him an activation, and B, to collapse that courage bubble, and hopefully using Wedge and my I took the 10-point rear gun for 4 black dice to punk out some sniper strike teams. Because that's a pretty good weapon for doing that with a surge crit. And so that was my grandiose plan. This game, from the get-go, is incredibly, incredibly, incredibly bloody. He tokens up Luke really hard on the approach, so I end up not wanting to take the T-47 at it while Luke is in the land speeder with a dodge token, because that's just, you know, asking to get some damage reflected on my airspeeder. And Luke did not have saber throw, so the only way my T-47 was going to take damage from Luke was if I let him. So I take some pot shots at the airspeeder, and I get a pretty okay roll, and his land speeder is just like, I'm just going to roll all the blocks on these surging white defense die. It's fine. I'll take one or two damage. My rebel troopers, however, though, taking some pot shots at said land speeder, just decided to throw crits. It was great. My sniper strike teams are getting some pretty excellent shots off, and I spend he hangs some people and scouts some of his strike teams up a little too far forward, where I think I get two of them, off the board turn one. He got a little too close to Sabine's gunslinger, so she's getting to gunslinger turn one, which is great, because I had recon intel on her. Clan Ren takes up a pretty defensive position where they can just jump up on top of a building next turn and stand over, and have range to both of his evaporators, because there's a building kind of in between the two of them. He's got his R2 kind of off by himself, trying to go on a little journey, but Sabine is between R2 and his victory point. So I feel like turn one positionally and dice rolly wise is going pretty good for me. Turn two rolls around, and it's a turn two Son of Skywalker into Jin. And I'm like, well, this is where I lose Jin. And then he mind tricks all my forces, and they all just kind of collapse off the board. But that's not exactly what happens. I play Rebellious. Jin's in charge range. So I get to hit, before Son of Skywalker goes off, I get to activate Jin, bonk him with Jin, activate Jin at the start of his activation, and bonk him again. And then Luke rears back his lightsaber, and he wants to just cut up Jyn with Son of Skywalker and then have a move action left to get on the evaporator or engage some troopers or do something. He doesn't take the aim token. And both attacks, he throws two hits.
Oh, that's gross. You should feel bad.
I do feel bad because Jyn got to feel go awful. First. So Jyn quick thinkings, and so I get to dodge one of those away, and Jyn takes two damage from Son of Skywalker.
Boo! Boo this man!
Boo this man!
She just bonked him on the show. Yeah, this was a friend of the show.
From a fake country.
But a fake country that we love quite a bit.
Right, we know it's not real, but we still love them. You know, it's fine.
I'm gunslinging my Sabine into some great spots. She's going to have an incredible turn three explosions on a good third of his army. I got two strike teams off the board. I'm making the other one fix evaporator. His sniper, or his DLTs and his rebel troopers, they have shots, but they're not great shots. He's shooting it like dodged up Mandos in heavy cover, and it's just not going great. And the words come out of his mouth: "This game is over on turn two. I should probably." I don't think he directly said I should concede, but it was around those likes. But we're like, we're having fun, we're chit chatting, we're gonna keep playing. And I was in an utterly commanding position.
Sure.
Sabine had to drop her shield on the approach, and I think she had taken two wounds. So Sabine's not feeling great. I'm obviously have to play Jyn cards to try to keep her alive. So I'm not getting order tokens to Sabine. Turn three starts. Luke rears his lightsaber back again, cuts my Jyn in half. I think he got 8 for 8 without a name token this time. Ooh. So the odds came back into his favor, and Jyn just evaporates.
Excellent.
He brings a DLT squad over and one-shots my Sabine. My Sabine rolled 2 blocks on the day.
Nice.
You deserve it.
So I now have Clan Ren, who doesn't have retinue tokens for the back half of the game. And suddenly we have a game again. The game state devolves into us doing some crazy trades. His better core infantry with the DLTs as opposed to my naked guys with medics. My troopers are kind of doing what they need to do. I'm keeping Luke busy because you know what Luke on sabotage doesn't want to do? Luke doesn't want to fix VAPs. Luke wants to swing his lightsaber.
Right.
And I'm making Luke fix VAPs because I had hit both of mine really quickly before he got to his, because it kind of felt like I was a little bit playing an Imperial player who's wanting to token up, who's wanting to take long range shots and get to the VAPs at the end of the game while I'm actively pushing on them. At one point we had, I think, R2-D2, a Rebel Trooper, Sabine, and Clan Ren all touching the same evaporator.
Oh, wow.
So oh, wow. Like, I fix, I break, I fix, I break, I fix, I break. It's like Sabine's trying to weld stuff on, R2's ripping it off. So we're like fix attack, break attack. and the game just gets absolutely bloody. When we come down to it, we play all 6 turns. And I had taken one of his VAPs and he had taken one of mine after we both fully fixed ours in the either fixed or broke the way we're trying to go for it. It comes down to points destroyed and he's got me by just shy of 80 points. He had a 3 or 4 hit point X-34 left, a sniper, not a strike team, a sniper, and like 3 rebel troopers and Luke. Who had a fair amount of damage on him, to a full health Clan Ren, a full health T-47, and like 2 Rebel Troopers. It was an absolutely disgusting game. It was so much fun to play. And to like the moral of the story, and the reason I wanted to talk about this game, is when things are looking like they're going to hell in a handbasket, their Sabine just may die. And you can pull your way back into a game. Dice are going to get rolled. Things can change. And you can pull games out. There was this really cool moment where I brought my T-47 around for this great flanking maneuver. My T-47's job was to hunt the Rebel commander. I was using Wedge to make sure I always had arc on him. And I just wanted to crush his leadership bubble. And that guy kept rolling like a champ. It was a really cool, like, 2 very different stylized lists, you know. A land speeder Luke infantry ball with a generic commander versus like Jyn Sabine Clan Ren with a snow speeder. So we both had heavies on the table. We both had lightsaber operatives. And our big operatives just kind of dodged each other going on opposite sides of the table from each other. And it was a really fun, really, really nail-biting match where, like, I thought he was dead turn two. When Jin didn't get evaporated by Son of Skywalker,
right,
and she can start to buy me more time, I was like, right, with Jin only being on two wounds and Luke not having a double attack anymore, Luke, like, Jin reasonably can survive one more attack.
Sure.
With Danger Sense, with all of her tricks. It was not to be, but it was a damn close game, and it was a lot of fun. One that I will wake up early to play anytime again. That was so much fun.
Well, I always will praise our Australian colleagues, especially when they beat Ryan. So bravo, here, bravo, Aussies, here.
Well,
bravo.
And I hear what you're saying, Ryan, about, like, you know, don't give up till the end and all that good stuff.
Oh, but
Tim,
but
should you have given up by turn two?
I mean, I played three games. I think I've played three games now, where two of those three this week, I probably could have just given up a turn two and it would have been fine. It would have
saved you a lot of time.
Yeah.
Saved you a lot of time.
I could have made some more food. I could have baked a cake. I could have, you know, baked some cookies. I don't know.
Tim, did you ask yourself if this would spark salt?
It all sparks salt. It all sparks salt.
Well, what happened?
I'll tell you. So I played three games this week. Three games.
Trois? And
because I am Imperial, all three have lost. So that's good. Now, that's what I say.
Boo-hoo.
Well, if we're being very honest with ourselves here, none of the three lists I played were probably good. Anything... No, some of them were decent lists, but I don't know if they were fully competitive. How about that? There's a difference between saying, like, okay, this could work, and saying, okay, this will hold up competitively.
Tim, nothing you play is fully competitive.
That's not true, but okay.
No. You can read that as a burn, but, like, you, like myself, tend to take off-skew lists.
Ah, that's right, Ryan. Put the salt on your backhand things, so when it hits me, it just has a little bit of extra friction to it. That's good.
Yep.
I don't like to back up Ryan, but against me, you played something very...
Oh, no, it's garbage. Yeah.
And your list against me wasn't bad.
My list against you wasn't horrible for what it was. It's trying to find, and I've talked about this on our show before. I actually just talked about it on another show last night. Like, it's trying to find that sweet spot for Imperials. Trying to find that,
wait.
That thing. What?
Another show?
Oh, yeah.
Are you cheating on us?
I am the Tennessee two-wheel. I ride around all around town. It's fine. I like to lend my voice to many different things.
Dear listeners, are you interested in playing Imperials and talking on the STABcast?
Right.
We are looking for a new host. Please make sure all submissions go to STABcast, because Tim doesn't have the email password.
But also...
delete them.
We're required to interview a certain number of people, right, but it will be Chris Beezer.
But also, on a side note, tune into Legion 99. They got a cool interview coming up. But anyway.
They were ahead of us on sponsorships.
But yeah, I played, I played against Griffin first, and then I played against Ben, and then I played against Will, actually, just a few hours ago.
You did.
Yeah, if you could call that play.
And I had a great time.
All three lists were very different, so I'm not going to go through and bore the listeners with every single list I played and everything I played. But basically...
list your sins.
It's been a different smattering of AT-ST and bikes and trying to figure out... against Will was AT-ST Devil Bike, which in theory felt good, but then I had four Ion Troopers with it, and that was the problem. It would have been fine against droids.
Tell everybody why you had four Ion Snow Troopers.
It would have been against droids or vehicles, none of which Will brought to me.
I brought all Troopers.
Yes, all Troopers, so my special things did nothing. Two white dice and one black is just not enough for 20 points.
Taps.
But anyway, and it taps. Snowtroopers, though, that's
Tim,
fine.
Tim works in psychology, so let's start with the psychology here.
Right.
Tim played a game against Griffin, in which he was, which was streamed by Endless on Yavin.
Yes, it should still be on his Twitch. It should still be on there,
You can see Ben delightful. And I. We were there.
Mm-hmm. We were there, chatting away, adding to the commentary.
We were encouraging our friend Tim.
Oh, I bet you were. Tim, quite I bet bit. You were, yep.
But Griffin brought the droids.
Yeah.
Oh, it was. Yes, he did. It was exactly everything I've been wanting.
He brought
for
what
quite
him and I
time.
Discussed as peak performance, which was like,
yeah,
Griffin
tends to do that. Yeah,
four B2s with all of them with Jesus. The new tech bot, ha. All of them with the ha. Funny you say ha. All of them with the ha droid. And so basically, what that means is that it ranged like two or three. I guess at range two because of their range, but at range two, you're basically throwing an AT-ST die pool with blast. Mm-hmm. With yes. blast. Now you don't surge hit, but you also have critical in there. Plus, you tend to have an aim token and some surges from the commander, so you tend to be able to get around that. So again, you're basically rolling an AT-ST pool with blast, and it is.
I mean that with like three or four aims sounds pretty scary. God.
It is rough.
we only get one aim, Will, because we're not allowed to share ours.
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
But it's still, yeah.
Why are
the
you
dice
bad?
Tend to hit hard.
Yes.
And then you reroll those whites and see
yes.
what happens.
So it was yeah. We played on the new Naboo map. It was a great map. Nothing, no complaints there. I think I brought a single bike. That's right. I want to see a single bike work. The
you
single
did.
Bike.
Yes, you did. Single bike?
Hey, the bike survived until the end of the game. All right.
Nice.
Also, because I called the game.
Targets to shoot.
But yes, I also called the game. So therefore, it survived to the end of the game. So, it's just the troopers got melted, and then game two again. We're not going to go through everything.
Those are important.
Yeah, game sometimes. Two against Ben. We had a lot of fun. We were playing on Edu, which has gotten pushed back to single limbs to just get a little bit more work on the map. But it was a cool concept. I really like it. It's got this big middle choke point, which for an AT-ST sounds great. But we played fortified defenses, right, Ben?
Yep. Key positions.
Yeah.
And major offensive.
And it all just...
Oh, you it, were so close to triple positions.
Yeah, there you should was, have played yeah, advanced I, positions, so you could have just been position.
That's. I don't know if any shots we made were not heavy cover. I think every yeah, I shot was heavy covered. There's probably a couple that weren't, happen. But pretty much everything.
That's
was
not true well, because hold on. My ha droids had blast.
Yeah, they had blast.
Oh, God. Boo! Boo! Yeah. So that was rough. Again, AT-ST stood strong while everybody died around him. It's all the pilots were up in the AT-ST, like looking at all their friends going there, like, oh my God, should we go down there and help? No, man. They're done. They're done.
Lock the door.
Yeah. Lock the door. Turn off the
Ewoks
lights.
Falling in the sea.
Yeah. We're not home. Don't tell anyone. And then the game tonight, just a couple hours ago against Will, was just a massacre. Again, it was basically done by turn
we'll get
two.
To that.
Yeah, it was basically done by turn two. So we'll all that to say, I don't know where that sweet spot is for those Imperials, but we are we're hurting. I'm trying not to hurt. I'm trying to find new things and new ways to work around things and
play IRGs.
The problem is, and I talk about this many times, about how many cool things we can do at range 3. The problem is, other factions do them better at range 3. And so we're just getting murdered. And it's, I don't know.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know. But yeah, it's been rough. Again, the main problem has been the core. It's the armor holds strong. The support's held strong. Like, dewbacks haven't given me too much of a problem. Like, against Griffin, I had a double dewback list. One died really quick because it got focused down and blanked out. The other one got right into the fray and did fine.
So does it become Rebel Troopers? Does it turn into Rebel Troopers where you just slap three naked storms in a list and build the other slots?
I'm starting to feel
more
that way.
Important things?
Yeah, the more lists I'm making now with tabletop in front of me, like, I'm starting to make more and more lists where I just throw... I tend to... the RTC is really good, so like I'll throw the RTC or the T21 on there just to give it a little bit of more oomph, and then fill it out with other things, because we have the other things. It's just trying to figure out how in the world to make it work. But yeah, we're hurting.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, after watching that game that Tim played against Griffin, I was like, oh, this is... This is everything I've wanted. This
ben,
is everything I've needed.
Careful.
Careful. Oh, it was a
family show. No. Family show.
So,
I guess we should say it was.
I would like to label
triple
this
step,
segment.
Double, quadruple B4, B2, sorry. Triple step, quadruple B4.
Yeah.
B2.
I want B4. To label my section a celebration of droids in 12 acts.
Act 1. Gross.
Ben was so into that list, he stole it.
I didn't. So no, I made this list based worse, on the physical components I have.
It was still
so
one.
So these are things I actually own. I don't own, you know, four B2s. I only own two.
Yet.
And so I have... Oh, yes, also
I'm expecting the painting bill soon.
I definitely went... I upped my order for the T-Series tactical droid, you know, that set. I'm going to get four of those bad boys, you know, just to be safe. So here's my list. T-Series tactical droid commander, two B2 super battle droids with the B2 ha trooper and the T-Series tactical droid upgrade. One B1 with the rocket boys, the PK series worker droid for a heal bot and an HQ uplink, and then another rocket boy with the heal bot, the worker bot, you know, to heal my own droid units. That is then followed by two more naked B1s that gave me space to have two BX strike teams with the sniper on them. And then, of course, three stabs, because let's just be honest, people, I can't stop playing stabs. They do my heart so good, so good. And like Tim said, we're on fortified positions, key positions, and then we did major offensive because I didn't want to spend the next hour trying to deploy everybody because I do have 12 activations. And
but that's how position, you're supposed to win.
No, it was gross. It's gross and it's horrible.
We actually went with the quad pass. I psyched him into it, so...
Oh, we're in the quad zone. Oh, no.
Yeah, this was the quad pass.
Oh, no.
He and I put our bikes on separate edges.
I do like the quad pass, though. Counterclockwise. Quad pass can be fun, you know.
It was... Because you and I both, like, you didn't want to give me bombing run, which was in the middle column. And if I passed on that the first one, you were going to pass through bombing run.
Yes.
So I didn't want to do that. So yes. I dared him to not do it.
Right.
And then he didn't do it.
That's right. We were pretty level-headed about it, and then we realized after we did 4-5 positions on that map, we're like, we've made a mistake.
Yeah, our feedback to the map makers, well, I like it. I like it visually. It is nothing but heavy cover, and then you add 4-5, it's just double heavy cover. I like the layers of the map, like it's got some height, but I put a barricade on top of a mountainside so I could hide my units walking under it from the AT-ST on the other side. So like it gave me visual cover because the rock was so high and the barricade on top of that gave me the cover to be able to hide behind it. So I could block line of sight from the AT-ST, which is really important because the AT-ST can see just about everything except my B2s. And I have my B2s pointed at Tim's bikes. And then my stabs are on the opposite side. They're going to swoop in looking like they're going to go shoot the AT-ST. I'm not shooting the AT-ST.
Well, no.
I am not.
No.
So I have a sniper in a weird spot, and I realized like very early I can probably run and shoot his bike with those two red dice and then the black white, which is kind of nice. Right. I can get some damage done with that. With the sharpshooter, getting rid of the cover.
Yeah.
You know, I've got a token there. We can make this work. Right. And I nearly get it, but I put enough damage in. So that's going to be super handy later. So he's got a wounded bike from almost the very start. My snipers get blown off the table, but it's 50 points well spent.
Yep.
I'm perfectly fine. But I have 12 activations, so I can manage to make my stabs go last. And that's exactly what they do.
Boom.
Seems good.
It is fantastic. They come around the corner. Start of the next turn, we're going to bring them in late again because I can. You know, we've got stuff set up. And I don't hit anything. I have aims.
Yep.
Wait, these are stabs, though.
I know. Normally, this like, oh, here's six black dice. Here's six hits. Or a crit or a couple, too.
Yeah, there's a couple of crits. That's because the only why thing not?
I've ever known. Yes.
I pop up and I'm like, well, there's Veers. I'm going to shoot Veers in the face. And Veers was like, no, thank you. Oh, that's not good. I'm going to shoot him again. Also, no, thank you.
No, thank you, sir.
So all three of my staffs are sitting, you know, within range of a couple of his units, which I have worried with some other stuff. You know, I've slapped around some guys. He's bleeding bodies just a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
So my stabs don't do anything. The problem is neither does his bikes.
Nope.
Well, that's normal.
That's actually not normal.
When his bikes come around the corner, I just hodroid the bejesus out of them.
Yep.
This is bullying.
Normally my bikes hit pretty good. They just tend to melt. But they were not hitting at all. They were not hitting at all.
I had some cover. I had some armor. Whew. And they weren't hitting.
Yeah.
And then my hod droids were like, thank you. Have another. Blah, and just blasted away. And on the next turn, I actually just recovered and did it a second time.
Yep.
So
sure did.
So Tim, might you think it's better to have agile instead of a surging defense tie?
It would be great, actually. It'd be a wonderful thing to be able to have that. I would love that. to be able to move, have a, or like move, have a dodge, and then, you know, maybe have two aims, aim and shoot. Cheating. Yeah, right. No. So, can't do any of that. No.
So here's the problem. I'm lighting up Tim's people directly in front of me. He can't advance into the middle key position because I'm going to fire into it with all the things I've got. I've got my commander hiding behind a tall line of sight blocker so he doesn't get blown up. I have B2s advancing on his key position, and I've got mine seriously locked down. So it only gets more disastrous. Because now I'm at range 3 of anything that starts walking towards the center. The Haws are approaching over the hillside. When Tim decides to call it a day, I roll the dice to see what would happen. It got
Can that be Tim's autobiography title?
Before Tim calls it a day?
Before Tim calls it a day.
Takeaways from my list. I love activation control, and the T-Series allow you to give tokens to the BXs, yep, which normally I don't have. So now I've got snipers with Pierce, which there is fantastic. Yeah. Or reroll if I absolutely need it. Getting those extra tokens, because I tend not to carry... lost my brain for a second. I don't use it anymore. What's it called? The thing that gives you the surges.
Aggressive tactics.
Aggressive tactics. Thank you. I don't use aggressive tactics anymore for the point cost.
Right. Right.
And I mean, even though I would get 4, I only get 4.
Right.
But having the reliable, having the bolster is also very handy there.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to figure out how to use worker droids because I haven't used heal bots in quite some time.
Yeah. And you barely use them in our game.
I found myself activating things wrong. Yeah. Oh, I should have saved that in case I needed a heal. Now, let's just be honest. Tim's white dice from those range 4 things, that didn't do a whole lot.
Yeah. Well, and I will say too, like the big thing with, I mean, and you touched on this, but I just want to emphasize, like your order control was so oppressive. Like it was so like everything else. Like, okay, I'm pulling out of my bag. I'm trying to get these the right tokens to pull, and then you're just over here like, yeah, I'll activate these guys last. I'm like, you sure? I'd really like to shoot them. He's like, no, I'll activate them last. Yeah. Meanwhile, I'm just pulling from the bag, hoping for the best.
Taking away the AI on the B2s is amazing. It is absolutely, they can go sit in the bag if I need to. They can go off and do things by themselves.
Yep.
Now, I am paying for 2 HQ uplinks, one on the STABs, one on the battle droids, which I probably don't need. But that gives me the flexibility to do what I want when I want. That's right. Go and sub in that. I do what I want. But it's well worth it. So when you've got that kind of control, you can order things in a way that saves the guys who need to go last, so they can go last. Tim got some decent hits on my STABs from a far distance, but I also had cover because the way that map is set and where they were, so I was able to survive a lot longer than he wanted me to, and then double move with some dodges.
Right. Yeah.
As is often the case, often I don't get to spend dodges on my STABs because everyone's rolling crits for some reason. So y'all stop that. But yeah, like I said, it was a fantastic fun game. It wasn't that fun for Tim, and I felt very, very bad for it. The position didn't help him. The map didn't help him. The fortified positions meant I lived longer because that's the one thing my B1s need.
Well, and also the thing with the choke point is like you might think like, oh, with a choke point, cool. The ATSD loves that. Traditionally, you're right. But when there's a bridge in your way... that bridge just gave heavy cover to everybody. Like, I can still shoot you, but you always had heavy cover.
Yeah. I had most of the time I had heavy cover.
Yeah, it was so frustrating.
Which means when my white dice blank out, it's not quite as bad because at least 2 of those went away.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Yeah. And those Haws, I mean, I get it. I mean, Tim was like, I was having flashbacks last night, my dreams, and now you bring me this, Ben.
Yeah.
What kind of friend are you?
Yes. Oh, my gosh. They're so good.
Two nights in a row.
But I mean,
that would leave scars.
But he knows I'm a droid man. He's going to be droid for life.
I took a couple night break, and then I was punched in the face by some clones instead. So it doesn't matter. I was going to say,
if you think Tim was having a bad week, just wait. There's more.
So I was supposed to play Will the next day. Yes. Had a headache. Had work run late. I apologized. Took a rain check. Partially because he was going to play an oppressive clone list against me. And I didn't want to see it.
My clones were frustrated. Our tokens were just ready to go, and then Ben left us hanging.
Yeah. Now, part of that is because Will had played a not-so-great clone list against Brett, and Brett beat the tar out of him.
Yeah, Sunday night, I played Brett, trying to make the commander tank work, and both times I've tried the commander tank, first of all, I have run into double-armor-heavy rebels, which has not helped with my testing. And then we played Fortified, which meant the tank's beam turret did nothing all game.
Yeah.
So it was a bad time. I'm working late. My head is hurting. Will's like, well, here's the list I was going to play against you. And I looked at it. I was like, ooh, I love that list. But now I want to go vomit. So,
I believe my head hurt worse. I believe Ben's phrasing was, this will remind people that clones are still a problem.
Yes.
After a few days of complaining about droids.
Yes.
So... I challenged Tim to a match before our game, before we recorded this evening.
Ugh.
And I brought forth my list of very balanced men.
Boom.
So balanced, so fair.
Everyone here is a clone trooper. We don't need no Jedi or no wheels, man. We're here to just walk and shoot you.
Walk all over you.
That's and did you know that when we walk, we get free aims? Because we have Rex with aggressive tactics and recon intel for the scout party, a generic clone commander, two phase twos with Z6s, two naked phase ones, and then three full arc teams.
That's awful.
All of which have targeting scopes, and then
Jesus.
One has a regular sniper, one has fives, and one has echo.
You're a horrible individual.
And this is this is 797. Yeah.
It's awful.
And here's the thing. He's doing targeting scopes so he wouldn't have to bring SA against us because he knew that would also be triply broken.
I told Tim at the start that I could turn my three scopes into six situational awarenesses. Yep. Although this isn't really a dodge sharing list. I feel like I need Padme for that.
Yeah, there's not a bunch of great ways for you to generate those.
And I knew that with the phase twos and all the arcs, I'd be more hungry for aim tokens. So I wanted the arcs to be able to spend them more efficiently. You know, only needing like two or three instead of three or four.
Ugh. Boo.
These are the things I have to think about in my degenerate land.
Oh, what a horrible burden for you to bear.
Such degeneracy.
I just want to put into perspective that I have to think about things so degenerately that you all moan whatever I would say, but there is a hierarchy in there.
Yes, on the hill of garbage that is the entire faction.
Good sir, I believe Will you mean my golden clone throne, where I shall sit.
Ben may rip that from you in the coming months.
How does it feel to become the oppressor, Ben?
It's about time.
Oh, okay. So the mask comes off. You were just jealous.
It's taken us a year and a half to get to this point. A year and a half.
These are all the real clones.
They haven't arrived yet. They'll arrive in like a week and a half.
It's February 19th, man. It's far off. But yes, I brought this in order to show Tim that he shouldn't just be afraid of droids after all. And then I saw what Tim brought and I kind of felt bad.
Yeah, that's fair.
Because like Tim said, he had four units of snowtroopers with ion guns.
Yeah, I did.
Against my no vehicle, no droid list.
Yeah, yeah, and I did.
You came for a droid fight and you got clones instead.
And then I started by suppressing two groups of snows with the air support, because turns out these cool new cards we get are kind of dumb.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, your beam turret with three dice. Oh, we'll talk about it. We'll get there. It does. Oh,
Rex opens up on two groups of snows and Veers standing together, rolls nine hits through the three die attacks and deals five wounds, I think, overall.
Yep, you did.
Into red saves.
Yeah. Yep, you did.
Yeah.
Sure did there, bud.
Yeah. So that started off great. We're playing on Hemmed In, and then we have Intercept the Transmissions and a Condition Card.
You typically do play with a Condition Card.
Well, I don't think it mattered.
No.
Or Tim forgot because that's his strategy.
No, it was hostile, but we were always touching cover, so it didn't matter.
Yeah, and
Yeah.
I only had two units that were Bravery 1, so...
Yeah.
Because he only has two units of Bravery 1.
I had seven units that were at least Bravery 2.
Jeez, ow.
Yeah.
I want high Bravery Rebel units. Aren't we supposed to be like the brave heroes that charge into battle?
Nope. No, you were tricked into it.
Yes.
My men were born for this.
Yeah, you have four people who know exactly what's going on. That's why they managed never to get shot. And then you have a lot of guys who are convinced to join a rebel army.
Yeah, you have goons and heroes. Every clone is
a hero.
But
my heroes are the same bravery as his goons.
No, every clone is a hero.
Yes.
I mean, yeah,
just look at what I did to Tim.
Yeah.
So I kind of put my three arcs kind of spreading out from the three points of Hemmed In since I was a blue player. I had one in this middle point, and then five was over on the left, Echo was on the right, trying to push those points. And Tim did a decent job killing arcs. It's just that at the same time, all of his troopers were dying quickly.
Oh, yeah. Exactly. Everything else died. Like I said, it was armor and bikes and stuff doing a good job. And then the cores are just like, but what if we died?
Your AT-ST kind of whiffed.
Oh, yeah. That's
true. Well, it hit once.
And your first set of bikes also didn't do a lot of damage. Like,
listen, it took them two rounds to kill four phase ones.
Guys, if I say that, people will say I'm just whining about the dice. But yes, you're absolutely right.
I will say that it's true.
No, I will stand up for you. I saw the thing happen.
Ben joined in to watch and enjoy the suffering until he saw that I was the one. The clones were dishing it out, and he was like, this isn't fun for me.
This isn't fun. I mean,
this is just sad. One of those,
yeah, oh, no. Tim has the surge guy, but it didn't surge that often. Or when it did, it was like, here's four. Now subtract for two for cover. He rolled two blocks.
Right.
Thanks, guys. Thanks.
I will say that aggressive tactics plus reliable three plus attack of the clones makes a lot of surge tokens.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, it does.
To where most rounds, I was basically surging on everything. So watch out for that if you're playing Legion. Sorry.
Yeah, it was quite the gross. I mean, there were some very nice shots where you fire supported some things and did terrible things.
Oh, Rex got nice. In the mix once half of Tim's army was dead. Yeah.
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 No, it was really just unfair towards Tim because I had this great position that I could kind of keep my token squads behind line of sight and pop out with phase twos or arcs and just bled it out and kill snows. And
So hemmed in on that particular map didn't work that well for Tim because there was lots of cover on either side. Yep. So when Will scouts everything forward, because everything goes forward except for like three guys.
Well, all the arcs scout two and then three units scout two with Rex. So it was, it was dumb.
It was a thing, but clone trooper sharing, perhaps it's perfectly fine.
It's fine.
It's fine. We're all fine here.
It isn't.
I continued bullying Tim, even though he wished to concede early, but we just decided to keep playing because it wasn't quite 8 o'clock for the the stream.
And the real thing for that was we didn't have enough time to do another game, and so I was like, we might as well just keep playing with this one. Like, we're having fun. We're still playing Legion. Like, all right, we'll just keep playing it
out. What they mean to say is when Will would kick Tim's body, a little fluid would still come out of it. So he just kept kicking it.
Yep. Yes.
Oh, he's leaking.
Exactly.
Veers was at a place. He's like, you know what? F it. I aim and I shoot with my three white dice.
Veers did quite a bit of damage with those arcs. He killed three of them.
Veers was one of my heavy hitters. Mm-hmm. He was doing great.
He was. He was, because he was the only body left.
Tim
he
did manage to panic my middle of the board arc squad, who had six suppression on them, and one guy was dead.
That's because they wouldn't die.
I was going to say,
six shots.
That's what happens when your whole army shoots them and nothing happens.
Listen, they were in heavy cover and with five surges around them.
No, sometimes they were just in light cover, but they had dodges everywhere and surges.
Well, that too.
Yeah.
Why doesn't your faction do that, Tim?
Yeah,
because I guess we're just bad.
Yeah, so we were having that conversation. Where do the Imperials exist right now on the competitive
level? In hell. That's where we exist.
And I don't know, Tim. I mean, now granted, it was Tim. I mean, I love you. I love you, buddy.
I don't know.
Maybe it's list makeup, but I've seen you try the ISFs. I've seen you try the other pieces.
Yeah, I've tried the more meta stuff. It's not like I've not.
I've watched the Imperial games on, on occasion on side of the Legion Discord.
Yeah.
I don't know where they sit.
I mean, Imperials aren't on their high horse that they were for a really, really long time. I think there's a lot of downtrodden on the internet. We just got these new models that have significantly changed the game.
That's and I want to see where of things, the century. Things,
well, yeah. I mean, same thing happened with Tawns and when Shores came out. Incorrect. We found ways to operate around them. When Strike Teams came out, we found ways to operate around them. So I think we need to give it some time. And we all four of us, we don't agree on many things at all. All four of us agreed that of the points update just, 2-3 months ago in November, the Imperials got by a fair margin the best end of it. And coming out of it, we're a pretty competitive faction.
It but
the
seemed problem, that way.
The problem that way. Isn't the points, and that's the real heart of the issue.
I can, it's, sure.
The problem isn't the point costs. The problem is we can't keep up with everything else. We can't keep up with the die pools. We can't keep up with the keywords.
Mm-hmm. Would you put Rebels in that same category then?
No. Look at your Mandos. Your Mandos do everything that Death Troopers want to do, that they could hope to God to do.
But the thing with Mandos, the thing that's frustrating with them is they can do all of these really cool things, but they need tokens to do it. And generating tokens on them is hard. Generating tokens is, as a Rebel player, is tricky. We're good at getting them on our heroes, but getting them to the rest of our army is something a little bit trickier. They're very good at a lot of things, but they're not.
It's not that hard for Clan Ren if Sabine's around.
It's not hard.
Other than that, it's not hard.
If Sabine's around, yeah. Other than that, a generic Mando squad, I feel, is a lot less powerful than Clan Ren next to Sabine, obviously.
Yep.
Which makes sense for your reasons, because they get that free token generation.
But they're also, by a country mile, some of the most expensive Rebel non-hero activations you can find.
Yes. So. But when I'm Rebel list building, everything I look at, I'm just like, wow, these are a value town, because I'm used to I'm used to my cheapest squad being 89 points.
Sure. So. Yeah. My things also peel right off the table.
Oh, like, they do.
One blank die. Yes, it's a surging red defense die, but on a Mando squad, you lose a model that you only have four of, and you paid 120 points for that activation.
I mean, blanks matter for me, too.
Yeah. Try as a Death Trooper. Like, what you've just described is a Death Trooper problem.
Sure.
But I'm not impervious.
I mean, I am, but I don't surge.
So. Get the hell out.
We're all kind of on different flavors here.
But the grown-ups are talking. DTs also have a lot more range.
And the grown-ups are talking. Yeah.
So, I have seen a lot of DT hate lately.
It's not hate. They're just shit.
I just don't get it.
They're expensive. Story days where they were suppressive in range 4.
They're expensive and they die.
They're still range 4. Yeah, that's the big selling point of them. Okay, neat.
They're still dead in a couple turns.
That's pretty good.
That's how Legion works.
But
you're right. All you non-Imperial players, please tell me how to play Imperials. Please, yes.
Exactly. Tim and I were talking all about these B2 battle droids. I mean, they throw the same dice pool the actual AT-ST does for 93 points.
Yep,
right. Now, granted, I've got to refresh to do some things. I don't have full armor. But
you're
now
also not 190
the
points.
And the hot trooper. Yeah, exactly. I'm not 190 points.
I mean, two of them for your AT-ST.
I'm at nine health. I am. I'm at nine health with the B2s as they sit currently.
Right.
And throwing that dice pool. And giving myself
the thing with the
surge.
Dice pool, though, is, and I definitely hear you, and I do think they are very strong. That unlike the AT-ST, that dice pool degrades over time.
Mm-hmm.
So that is something to bear in mind as they take damage, which, you know, but if they're on the field, they should be taking damage.
You juke and jive behind some rocks. What?
I mean, if you get them in heavy cover, they're canceling three before dodges, so they're tough. They're tough to move, but I mean, I could just, you know, shoot.
Well, unless your opponent is playing one of the new factions that has critical everywhere, and then your cover and armor doesn't matter.
Exactly.
This goes back to the point that I'm with Tim. I haven't seen the units and the cohesion to generate the tokens. And that's always something that even now that I'm generating more tokens, at least command tokens, it has been a little worrisome when we start getting into that place of gameplay.
Right.
Of, you know, how many surge tokens can Will generate a turn?
Sure.
It's a lot. I'm not taking aggressive tactics because I only get four.
And the issue, too,
but Will gets four plus all the other things.
The issue, too, is like looking at the AT-ST, like, okay, it's a great die pool, surge hit with the pilot, great, no complaints there, it's fine. Against armor, it's impact, what, 3, 4, whatever? Like, it's great. Mm-hmm. The problem is that critical, it doesn't sound really crucial, but it hurts a lot versus troopers.
I've been crying against critical since the Clone War box came out.
Yeah.
You have been.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah.
And I will say, Tim, you haven't played Shores in a while, and is that maybe the time to go back to them?
They got that hike.
Yeah.
That's true.
I don't think they're DOA.
No.
I still think
they're really
efficient. They're really effective. But it's not something you mainline like you used to. You take a unit of Shores.
I've been experimenting a lot with my more serious list of double Shore single mortar, because I don't mind one mortar to do what a mortar's supposed to do, like a little bit of suppressive fire. That's it.
But, sure.
Maybe double mortar, but then you're running out of thumbs and it makes me nervous.
Right.
Yeah.
I will say, when you were playing on the stream the other night, your Dubacs received quite a bit of hate from the crowd.
Well,
not just
again, they did okay.
But they did.
There were dozens of us.
Well, but it's not because I think they hate Dubacs. I really think it's because Dubacs aren't quite in a place where they're as good as other units.
for the point cost.
Yeah.
And I know that came down.
I guess. But again, I like D-backs too much to be objective about that.
Right. I feel like I'm with you. I mean, but I get, but I think objectively, I don't think they're quite as good as you would like them to be.
Sure. Yeah, that's fair.
Do you, Tim, do you object to just playing the new Imperial Special Forces unit? Because I've heard that they're actually pretty decent. I just haven't seen
they're very good. They're very good.
I haven't seen you using them, so I wonder.
No, I'm not against them. I just making them fit and making them play how I want.
I mean, okay. Infiltrate on a red save seems pretty dope.
Infiltrate is a trap. Don't do it. Infiltrate.
Well,
is a trap.
You got to learn how to infiltrate. And guys watched me murder Jin or and Pathfinders just, how many times before I figured it out.
That's why you just don't do it.
But it's, yeah, I saw Jin a lot because she infiltrated too.
If you don't love, Jin, you never have to get hurt. It's fine.
Now, I'm also partly with Tim with this. I've only infiltrated once with Cad Bane, once with Maul, and then I was like, I'll never do this again.
Yeah. You're like, oh,
it was
this is
once
awful.
Successful with Maul by accident, and it was not successful at all with Cad Bane. So
I've infiltrated once with Padme, and it worked out beautifully. Can't imagine why it worked out for Padme, but not Cad Bane.
I mean,
they're basically the same unit.
Yeah, it's just one's 35 points more.
Yeah.
I'm with Tim and his, slight frustrations this week. Now, partially, it's also the list he's coming up against. All three of those were, brand new. They're in the new, they're in the Civil War.
Yeah.
The first one.
They're new hotness, and we are ramping up towards a competitive season event.
Right.
And so some of us may have had more powerful lists than we might normally bring.
This has been me, this past week has been me throwing things against the wall and seeing what sticks, really.
Yeah.
And so far,
it's not a fair gauge.
Nothing?
Yep. So far, it's just about nothing.
None of this has worked. And I get why you want to bring the AT-ST. I do.
I think the tank is just better.
I think the tank is better. I do. And it's mostly, and this is going to sound crazy, it's not better. Because it's not as tall.
Yeah.
Because I could shoot that AT-ST which is by anything I wanted to because I could see it.
I never shot Tim's AT-ST. Yeah, I just let it shoot me for fun.
No,
I
mean, I'm never worried about
getting finding
shot.
11 wounds is tough. Yeah. Finding even though it has the white save, like who cares? Finding
it wasn't
11
tough for Ben.
And the armor.
He's like, I have impact 8 in this list.
I mean, yeah, you're not wrong.
But I will say on TTS, the maps are tight. And so getting a Gav tank in a spot where you can do a thing is also a little bit harder.
Yeah, that's true.
That's true. Now let me ask you this, Tim. What upgrades do you take in your AT-ST?
Oh, the
obviously
twin blaster.
The Surge Pilot.
Surge Pilot.
You take a twin blaster?
Surge Pilot, it has to be stapled on there. That's it. Like, that's done.
Yeah, I got.
And then the twin blaster. And if I can fit the points, I'll absolutely take the mortar, because the mortar's cash money.
I love the
grenade launcher?
The black die blast grenade launcher. The concussive grenade launcher.
Never pays off. It never pays off.
So the last time I played the AT-ST, I also had it, but I was also playing Weiss because I'm a madman with an HQ uplink, and I just spent all my time refreshing and shooting.
It is so alluring. It sounds so good. I'm telling you, it so rarely ever pays off.
When someone sees your AT-ST walking towards them to shoot them better with that, they get a little scared.
Okay, neat. But they kill your core and they still lose. Like, that's.
I mean. This is all true. This is all true.
But it can delete core troopers, man. Like
yeah, but I don't need blast to do that.
It's walking light cover. I don't know. I think of it as two hits that are always going to come up just to ignore cover when you get to use it. So it's what, three black dice by itself, or is it two?
I don't know.
Tim goes to take a
shot at one of my guys. But he has to shoot through the toes of the AT-ST, giving me the light cover.
Yep.
That's why you touch it.
The mortar, the concussion grenade launcher is two black dice. And the other problem
I kind of think of it as four dice, two of which will always be a hit.
The other problem is that it's 15 points. Still? That is damn expensive for that unit. Doesn't matter.
Blast is a really good keyword.
Yet again,
I see that
your units can have blast for a grand total of 93 points.
Yeah, this is true. I mean, this is all very true. My hot trooper throws two red and a white at range two with blast and impact, 30 points.
Well, you know where my army gets blast? That refreshable fleet trooper guy.
And he's only like 60 points, bro. He's coming back.
So, As crazy as it sounds, if you want to see pictures of the fleet troopers that I painted this past week, I'm posting them to the Instagram. You can actually check out all the models I painted. I got a little bit of time over Christmas. I'm going to finish basing them tomorrow. They look beautiful. I'll post them on our Instagram at SWStabcast. Check them out.
Be sure to also check out our Facebook and Twitter and rate us on iTunes or subscribe to us on Spotify. We appreciate you listening on whatever platform you choose, where we are always available at SWStabcast.
And then also you can find us on the Legion Discord, especially in this time of Invader League. We are all over it. Ryan is the lowest of the judges, but he is a judge. And then
you're a judge, but we do not give you the rank of master.
That's right. I'll be streaming some games, probably be getting knocked out of the single elimination contention before long, so that way I'll be streaming
with more. That kind of attitude.
It'll be great.
You said that last time it went 5-0.
Yeah, well, yep. We'll just keep our expectations low and I'll never be disappointed by myself, although I still
there
manage.
There you go.
But, and then you can find all of us on the Discord at STABcast, insert name here.
Correct. Where we'll be happy to be summoned.
You can email us, communicate with us on any of our social platforms or at swstabcast@gmail.com. We also have a Teespring shop where you can buy shirts or hoodies, or I'm going to go ahead and call it until someone else makes another one. I'm going to say on our Teespring shop, you can find the official Star Wars Legion fanny pack.
Oh, wow. Not it's, official it's been from the best. From. Hold on. Not as official as From the Mouse, not officially licensed, and we have no official licensing from the Star Wars company Disney company.
That's why I said Legion. That's why I didn't say Star Wars Legion. I said Legion.
Okay. Neat.
It might catch on.
Yeah.
It might. Who knows? And until somebody else makes another one, I'm going to call it that. Go buy yourself one of those. They tend to be trending on the Discord as of late.
That's true.
For keeping your tokens in there, and you can shake them with a good old hip thrust.
Right. You can shake them around, unless you're a droid player, in which case all your tokens are already out on the board.
Yeah, so. I don't
just like the other sack near your waist.
That was too much.
That was good.
Too much.
That was not.
Will.
Sorry, a cat's climbing me. Hold on.
Yeah, I heard her meowing before.
Eat your face. Eat his face.
The Facebook thing.
I know. It was very subtle.
Will has
meow,
recently
though.
Adopted a murder animal.
Yeah,
Daisy has stood up on the back of my chair.
She's fine.
Hello.
She's fine.
Are you good?
She's just catting. Cool. Let her cat.
Yeah. She was using my arm as the ladder, so I was just not wanting to cry out. But anyway.
I love these discounts on these points and things and these new units. That's great.
Be a man. Take your pain.
That's right.
The news.
The news.
There was some news right as our episode was about to come out because FFG knows.
Hey, we actually got our episode dropped first this time, so that's nice.
Did it not come out on Tuesday that week?
No, it came out Wednesday afternoon. We loved we went Wednesday morning.
It's true. All right,
so everyone that listened after reading this article thought we were even dumber.
Which is most of everyone, but that's fine.
Which is
if we had lower to go, I'm impressed. Anyway,
but listen, this is how we summon the article. We understand that we are the sacrifice in order to get that done.
So correct. When we'll say there's no news that summons FFG or Atomic Mass or whoever's putting these articles out now to put forth some news to make us look dumb.
My news senses are tingling. And behold, the OP droids have gotten the expansion they wanted.
Oh. It's everything I wanted. I may have teared up a little bit. It worked. Like I saw it. There were like 900 messages. I was a little busy. But then I was like, I stopped in the parking lot. Literally, I told someone I was leaving. It's like 5:30 by the time I'm leaving. And I've been there since 6:30 that morning. And I'm in the parking lot just scrolling through. And someone walks. I was like, why have you not left yet? And I realized it's 6:15 because I'm reading the articles and all the chat about it.
That's about right.
So because Ben will be far too emotional, I will go through the droid cards that have been spoiled.
That's true. That's fair.
So I believe we had seen the T-Series tactical droid upgrade before.
The upgrade version, yes.
Yes, but we were spoiled with the tactical droid commander unit.
Beep,
which
boop,
Ben has been salivating for since droids came out, I believe.
Yeah,
gross.
I've needed it for
probably
so
before.
Long.
Basically. He's so been long. Whining about his commanders since the game came
How
out.
How this wasn't the first the expansion, I don't know.
Because you can't put this in your big box.
No, I'm saying put this in the first. I've already had one droid expansion.
Right.
Ace
I got Rex, and you got Dooku, which are about the same point cost. Or at least they feel like they should be. But like we kind of predicted, this gets bolster and direct, the keywords that were shown in the new RRG.
Yeah, bolster gets, too.
Gets sharpshooter, command slot, comm slot, gear slot, which is interesting. A comm slot on a commander. I don't know that we've had that before.
Does seem a little odd. But
it's a droid. You can you can run comm jammer commander if you want.
As I suicide into the other people.
He is only...
I can see throwing an HQ uplink on him.
I can't, actually. I can't. Mostly because that clears that token out of your bag. I can't,
right. Because I honestly think even if you're wanting to run a Grievous or a Dooku, I could really see slotting one of these guys in and getting hit, you know, your other commander token out of your bag could be pretty helpful.
Well, and bolster on like a Grievous one pip, not bolster, sorry, direct when you have those Jedi one pips that only order one unit could be really cool.
Yeah,
direct. To let the droid party still happen.
So good.
Yep. He's ranged 1 to 3, which is pretty dope.
Yeah, he's got that red-white.
Red-white die. So the red die will probably get absorbed by cover, but he is sharpshooter 1. And he's range 3, something me and Tim wish we had.
Yeah.
No, no, that's absolutely, that is very nice. I mean, I have a white defense die, but you know, so does everyone else. So it's
So this guy is just around to let you take all sorts of other things in your list. And luckily, this pack comes with all sorts of other upgrades.
Yes, it does. Because we've already been talking about the T-Series Tactical Droid upgrade. With this reliable and losing stapling the AI attack.
B2s. Yep, it's even like the B2s in the picture.
It's got a B2. Yeah.
18 points. It is so cost effective on those B2s. It is beautiful. Having now played it once, I'll never take it off that set again. I had to call the store to increase my order. I was like, I need two more, guys.
He did. He's up to 4. I'm waiting for him to get to 6.
Two of them are stapled directly to the B2s.
6 B2s.
So I needed two more.
With and double generic
tactical commanders. Yep.
But we also get the medical droid and worker droids to give repair and treat 2.
Yep.
Oh, well, love them.
The keyword 1, capacity 2s.
Yeah, 14 points for that medical droid, though, to keep your Grievous, Dooku, Cad Bane, or Maul alive is absolutely bonkers.
Or repair 1, capacity 2 for 12 points seems pretty cool to keep your B2s or B1s alive.
Yeah.
It's cool that they're a little more expensive than their counterparts. You know, I know the Rebel is 8 and I think the Imperial is 9. So they are more expensive, but the amount of utility you're going to get out of them bringing BXs back,
I think
putting
it's
B2s
because
back on the table. Yeah.
Because those guys aren't your main repair source, unlike droid troopers need repair. And then, rather than a comms upgrade, because every droid unit so far gets that regardless, we have a recon droid.
Recon.
Because they needed more observe, I guess.
Well, and more just dice.
That too. He does throw white, range 1 to 2 on his own.
For 8 points. He's 3 more points more expensive than a normal just body.
Yep.
Yeah.
To give you rerolls and 2 white dice instead of 1.
I like it. I do. I mean, I really like it. I haven't played it yet. I mean, partially because Observe for me is now, you know, it's locked behind getting Maul. So
right.
So you pay the 160 Maul tax. But now that I can do this.
But
I mean,
now your useless B1s can give those B2s all the rerolls with Observe too.
Mm-hmm. All right. I'm going to say something, and Ben, you can tell me I'm wrong. And that's fine.
Warming it up.
You're wrong. That's fine. Okay. I can kind of see putting a Viper Recon Droid in a B2 squad.
Mm.
So here's why I say nay to that. Because it's an action, not a free action.
Yeah. I'm not. It's 8 points for a wound on a B2 unit. Its die pool isn't obviously as good, but it still benefits from that armor keyword.
You're never going to get Ben to not get rid of AI attack.
I mean, that's the thing. For 10 more points, the tac droid is better.
Yeah.
Range 3, red die.
He just hates being forced into things, man. Like,
And I get that, but an 8-point wound on those bad boys sounds real sexy.
What about, worker droid to repair them instead.
You know, everyone's like, well, you know, you could just staple binoculars to your B1 droid so they can shoot and then give an aim to somebody next to them.
They are allowed to equip them regardless.
But this is the same point cost to give me 2 extra dice and an extra body.
Right.
With an observe 2.
And
which
essentially,
anybody can use, not the
essentially
guy next
one
to me.
Aim.
Yeah. Essentially one aim for anybody on a field, not the guy directly within range 1 of me.
Yeah. It's almost like sharing tokens.
Yeah. No, I think they're going to be killer on B1s. Absolutely killer.
I absolutely think so. Love them.
I think all four of these unit upgrades are really cool.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah.
I really do.
And then we had seen the mechanized incursion card for droids, the new one pip.
So yep. The one time I tried to play it against him, my vehicles were on the wrong side of the map. I could only
the one vehicle. Maybe you should try long range comlinks.
Hold on, but you still had like perfect order control that way anyway.
I did, because of HQs.
Yeah.
Like, I couldn't actually order the vehicle. I just had a one pip. So I just played it as a one pip because the vehicle was too far away from my, because I didn't have long range comms.
Still did it.
Because HQs.
Man pays 20 points for perfect order control. Imperial players hate him.
Yeah. Yeah, we do.
News at 11.
We do.
But we also got the new two pip and three pip that will be arriving with this set. We have a two pip orbital strike, which is very cool and not overshadowed by anything. It allows a friendly droid trooper commander or a field commander unit to perform a free attack after it activates, which is black, black, red, red, suppressive, and immune deflect. So take that, lightsaber boys.
Right. It does have the big command card for due to infinity restriction, so you do got to poke somebody a long way away.
You cannot do it at range one. Sadly.
So it's a lesser Veers, but a two pip, and gives you a little bit of flexibility there, either your commander or your tank.
Now, it's kind of nice. However, it is a two pip that only orders one thing.
Yes.
Which does feel a little bad.
But
you're also droids, so you just pop those HQs and don't care.
Yeah, exactly. you're fine. Yep.
You use your direct from your brand new T Series tactical droid. Everything's fine.
I think it is odd to give this card and another certain card away as a generic upgrade. You know, kind of thing, over push, when the other cards that have attacked things have had to been strapped to 90-point units.
Right. That's true.
But we did it anyway.
We sure did.
We sure did.
Now, and I will say, suppressive here seems a little surprising.
They want you to play Droidicas, Ben. Mm-hmm. Embrace it. Embrace Droidicas.
I may have to. Do you love me some Droidicas?
You could put 8 suppression on some fool.
Droidicas are cool.
Droidicas are real cool.
But the problem is that they're not stabs.
Right.
The real problem. Yep. Droidicas are great units. They're just not stabs, which are bananas units.
What if you could be speed 3 and shoot? Wow.
And pass orders.
And pass orders and receive orders easily because of their comlinks.
So. And take aim tokens for free because have whatever the stupid comm upgrade card is.
Yep, the link targeting array. Because my buddy gave me that order token. Yeah, it's going to be real hard for me to pass that up for a while. It is.
Yeah. That's
fair. Then we have a 3-pip. Roger.
Oh, this is, yep.
Orders 3 droid troopers, and when a unit is issued an order using this card, so not everything on the droid field, thankfully.
Just
the 3 orders from this card. A unit ordered can gain either 1 dodge or 1 surge token, which is interesting.
Yeah, it's interesting that it's a dodge or a surge, not a dodge or a name.
Yeah.
It's interesting.
Yeah. And I'll be honest, so when I played this against him, I gave 2 of those orders to the B2s.
Yep.
And then a third one to a B1, who then, of course, initiated the chain. So, you know, good times are had by all.
I actually really like these to use, order just 1 B2 squad to start your chain and then 2 BXs to get those dodge tokens up to keep those little guys alive.
Well, B2s don't pop it, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, like B2s can't share.
Only B1s. Yeah. Only B1s share the token. But if your commander's in the right spot.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
No, I think these are all really cool, though.
They're all great cards.
Yes.
Yeah, they are.
Ben, absolutely. Ben just wants to play Roger to look at that command art some more.
Mm-hmm. Look at that command art.
Of all those clones just dying on Geonosis.
Clones just... Absolutely.
I understand, because there was also another upgrade pack that was spoiled.
There was.
So we may have sparked some negative feelings, I think.
We got the clone version. So, like, cool. 55 points. Exactly the same keywords.
I think I might need to cover this too, because I think Ben's going to get too emotional again. But in the opposite direction.
In the wrong way. So it's exact same keywords. Bolster 2 for an action. Direct a core clone trooper unit, which does help a little bit.
Yeah.
Sharpshooter 1. Command slot, training slot, and a gear slot. It throws 3 black dice at range 3.
Mm-hmm.
4 health, 2 courage, a red die. A red die. Now, that surprised me, because it's exactly the same thing as my...
Yeah, it's the same thing, and, like, it does have a better defense save, and it has a better attack pool, but does so much more for you than it does for clones.
Sure, except, free fire support.
Okay. I was going to say, I don't know about that. I think
it's one free fire support rather than triggering your chain without even, having to work for it. I think it's just you can just that direct, you can get most of your bag emptied out.
I think it's just this very different very things. That's all.
Yeah. Yeah, that's very different things. So, I mean, like I said, nothing too terrible there. And again, it plays well. It is also 55 points. When you have a 90-point Rex, so it's a little, you know, when you start making choices for that, you start looking at command cards or if you carry both of them.
Right.
Still not the same amount of points as, you know, possibly, you know, an Annie or an Obi, so...
It's only 35 points up to Rex, which is less than most units in clones. So if you're in that weird zone, you can probably just up price to Rex.
Right.
Since RT-2 is now 45 points.
But he's definitely solid. Very solid.
Oh, he's great.
Oh, yeah. Very, very solid. So this is going to sound crazy, but we're going to get into the slightly controversial zone, which is the clone medic and the clone engineer. Now, we knew they could already shoot. We knew that they would not have the non-combatant trait.
Correct.
And that they treat one capacity one or repair one capacity one. So they don't get to repair a lot.
Just one.
They don't. But when you use the repair, they get to keep shooting for the rest of the game, which seems real handy. Now, our friend B's, friend of the podcast, believes that they're both hot garbage and should never be used in a list. And 20 points for the medic and 18 for the clone engineer.
I get it. I don't know that I have a strongest stance of him, but I get it.
Yeah.
No, I definitely don't. But I understand the fact that if you're bringing something to heal, you kind of want it to just heal. So, like, you would trade the capacity two for the die not working most of the game.
Right.
And here, that's just...
I don't know that a faction that can share dodges and surge tokens for blocks and roll red needs the ability to pull back more bodies.
Well, when I only have 18 wounds...
That's a you problem rather than a me problem.
When you have 62 to my 18, the healing feels worse.
I don't know. How many dice do you roll with all the modifications?
Depends.
Depends.
So I get it. I understand that people are a little afraid of that. Cost is a little high. Depends on what you want to do with it. If that clone engineer is what keeps your R2-D2 alive for the extra point, that ain't bad. If it's what helps you put more wounds into a unit for that extra treat and still getting to shoot. I mean, it is 10 more points on a phase one. It's, you know, 7 more points on a phase two. Mm-hmm. But it's an extra body there that gets you a heal. I kind of like it.
Yeah, for the 20... I mean, that medic is probably better than the commander as a 20-point unit upgrade.
Yeah.
But it's also a 20-point unit upgrade.
It is. But you put fives on a phase two using your clone commander to give fives, who's not a clone trooper core unit.
He would be.
Now he's giving. I mean, now you're giving out two order tokens there.
So that is two free tokens per round, yes.
So let me pitch it this way. Your phase one bros, you said, are 10 points, right?
Yes.
So for two phase one bros, you can get... two wounds, which your medic also gives you, and two black dice as opposed to one.
Right.
Mm-hmm. The only time I see you taking the medic is in a Jedi list, when you need an extra wound on an Obi-Wan or an Anakin.
That, and when I was building that arcs list I talked about earlier, I thought about including one just to keep an arc alive a little longer.
Sure.
Because those arcs are up there at, like, I don't know, it's like 18 per model or something.
Yeah.
But if you're using your heal charges on phase one or phase twos, I think it's better just to grab the bodies.
No, I don't think that's what they're for. They're not to keep your unit they're attached to alive, unless they have no other option, and then they can just do that.
Well, as someone who's played medics for a long time, a lot of times just the way the activation order comes out, you have to go with your medic squad. And you're like, well, this guy's going to die before he gets to activate again, so I might as well bring back this guy I don't really care about because the Mandos are way over there or Luke's way over there.
When I played them, because I haven't played bots ever, and like I said, I haven't played a heal bot in forever.
Mm-hmm.
So I activated, and I was like, oh, I should have saved that to bring back a B1 body, I guess.
Right.
And at some point, they're far enough away, I was like, I guess I'll just heal this B1 unit.
Right,
And unlike Ben, I don't get to just call that, so a lot of the times it might just get pulled out of the token bag and go, oh, well, I guess my medic's happening now.
Exactly.
Yeah. I think they're going to be good if you bring them, but I don't think they'll be auto-includes by any means.
Right.
And then there's a fourth upgrade card that doesn't matter.
I think the sleeper card here is the clone comms technician.
No.
For 12 points?
Who cares?
12 points? You can do some things with that.
No, because I have to spend at least 5 more.
For a nice comm upgrade?
Like what?
Link targeting array.
can't take it.
Yeah, I can't take that. That's the only one that's good. The rest are all funny.
The only place I could really see you maybe grabbing the comms tech, maybe, is when you have a phase two squad with, is it Fives who gets coordinate?
He's the coordinate. But
and an HQ. And that's a big fat maybe.
May I counter that in an ARC squad, they already get the comm upgrade, and you just put the HQ on that instead and stay and it's save points.
True. There you go. You got it now.
I mean, so. Did you get the extra body that shoots?
Yeah, you get the sixth man. Like, sometimes the sixth man can make a difference. But yeah, no, I agree. I don't think it's a great card.
He's there.
I think what you're going to do is you're going to do what I do with a lot of my tenacity and hunter, most of my hunter cards, and you're going to flip them over because they have the same picture on the back, and you're going to take a Sharpie and you're going to write clone medic for your practice games at your local game store so you have a proxy card.
There you go.
I'm probably just going to end up using the comms technician model in squads. It's like, look, it's just a guy with a backpack. Whatever.
Because I think I've got three copies of Hunter that just have either offensive push or situational awareness drawn on them.
Yep.
You comms relay into that ARC team. That's all. Comms relay into that ARC team, which is a little bit outside of range three. But they're all good. They're all good. But then we get to their cards. I mean, the command cards. And this is where things, once again, gets a little wonky.
This is where Ben gets jealous offensive. Of me again.
Well, actually, the one pip we weren't really super jealous of.
Like, they're about the same.
About the same. I think it actually is slightly better for the CIS unit.
I would say it's significantly better for the CIS unit.
I mean, it's cool for clones to be like, oh, I order this ATRT and can get a fire support squad at the same time.
Yeah. Yes. I mean, for all the same reasons, direct is better for the CIS than the clone commander.
Right.
It's their tubes pip, their air support.
The
artwork is nothing but droid death, and we don't appreciate
that. Now, listener, I'm going to be going to my closet of these guys are going to complain for 30 minutes, so if you'd like to join me, feel free. Y'all go ahead.
So same thing as before. Either you give it to your commander or gives a token to it's a tank unit, a heavy unit. Once per round, at the end of the activation, the friendly commander clone trooper unit or friendly field commander unit. So it does have to be Rex or the 55-point guy.
Yes. No Jedi is using air support
until Commander Cody comes out or friendly field commander unit. It may perform an attack using the following weapon, range 4, red, black, black, beam 2.
Gross.
Yeah.
No, thank you.
Now, I will say, Will has seen with all the cover, beam 2, when you just have, you know, the two little red dice, sometimes just doesn't do anything.
Correct.
Right.
The problem is it's at 3 dice. So you've already shot with your actual thing. You've done the attack.
Well, no, you haven't. Because you have to be at range 4 to whatever.
Right. So you've attacked something else. So now you're attacking beyond that.
Maybe. How many times does Leia shoot and then you CB, Ben? Come on.
Yeah.
Don't because you...
No, Leia's, because Leia's this is bad. The same kind of thing. Short range unit gets this long range bang. It's
the other interesting rules question that came up when this card got spoiled that we kind of had to hem and haw over a bit was, can you walk the beam back? Does just the first target have to be, you know, 4 to infinity, and then can you attack somebody with the first beam, somebody at range 3 and then range 2? And all of the attacks have to fit the weapon profile. So, like, the one way to curb it is all of the attacks have to be very far away.
Right. Yes.
So there is some counterplay there.
Well,
which is nice.
You're doing it from a tank, and you're beaming the first time, and now you're beaming the
more
times.
Don't talk about the tank like it's a good plan, Ben. I've done it.
The only thing with the beam is, like, the way you can get around that is that you can still daisy chain it, because it only has to be within range 1 of it. It can be within your minimum attack range. That's fine, as long as it's range 1 from the last thing you shot.
From the 4.
Yeah.
So it can still can be closer. That's fine.
And like we talked about with that attack, Will rolled 9 dice, managed to get 5 kills on red dice units. Against me, my white dice is mostly like, well, thank you, sir. I will pick these 3 models
Except
up.
Except when I used it against Brett's white dice units, who were all in heavy cover, and I was using it with a tank, I did nothing.
You did nothing.
It's going to be a situational card that's very good on Rex and okay on the commander and not very good on the tank. There you go.
Yep.
Yeah.
I mean, but if you're using just the base commander, though, I like it for the generic, because you're likely not advancing that far up with him. Rex wants to scout out. He wants to be a little bit closer to his
weapon.
It's a
turn 1 card for Rex if you don't TTC.
Yes.
Commander guy, it's cool because he at least gives it sharp 1. Mm-hmm. The tank, when I used it, it was just kind of sad.
Yeah, it was kind of sad.
Without surging, so it was like 1 or 2 hits on each one, and then it was no cover ignoring, so all of... And again, we're playing fortified, so it's a little different, but
yeah.
Brett, I think Brett lost 1 vet to the tank's beam cannon turret and air support. So, granted, that was six suppression, but then he inspired it all away and did rebel things to it.
Will tried to beam a whole bunch of Mark IIs, and they just refused it.
Those Mark II blasters just wouldn't die.
Meanwhile, he beamed me and killed everything, so it's fine.
Because
so.
I used Rex, who has sharp one, against your guys in light cover, and he rolled 9 out of 9 hits.
That's exactly right.
And you rolled 4 out of 9 blocks, which is, you know, only one. Roughly it's one face off of where it should be.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
So we go back to the, like, oh, mine had suppression. That's our suppressive. That's interesting. So then we get to the three pip for the clones, which is attack of the clones. All right, nice. Like it. Order 3 clone troopers. When a unit is issued an order using this card, it either gains a surge token or removes a suppression token.
Yeah. So, hey, I heard your faction didn't have much inspire, so here you go.
I was okay. And most of his units currently have, you know, a courage of 2 anyway. It seems odd. And then we're like, oh, we should give him surge tokens. But at this point, build a mountain out of those things. You might as well put surge on the card.
I just want to be death troopers, okay?
I mean,
legit, no, you don't. I mean, you don't want to be us right now.
I just mean surge on both. That's all I want from your card.
Okay, that's fair.
Not the points cost or whatever else is on there.
No, nothing else is on there.
So the real question is, if you're playing nothing but generics, are you ever going to take this card?
Yeah.
Are you? Sorry, may have phrased that poorly. If you're bringing the high level commanders, are you ever bringing this card? I say probably not.
I mean, if it's like an OB Rex kind of list, I would rather have Rex's 3 pip than this card. Sure.
That's what I'm saying.
I think solo commander, you bring this.
Here's the thing. I think this is still a better generic than any of the Rebel or Imperial generics.
Well, yeah.
Well, that's normal.
that's par for the course. I've
forgotten which factions we're talking about. We're not talking about the old guard. We're talking about
Try making a point that wasn't obvious, man.
Oh,
it's like American Gods.
I feel bad, man.
Sad now.
I play Rebels too when I want to feel better about my morality in this game.
I will say and that for me, for the CIS, these upgrade packs are opening up a world of new things.
Yeah, they are. They're so good.
They are a paradigm shift for droids and some cool stuff for clones.
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely. This definitely, I think, you know, we had clones up in the S tier for a while by themselves, and this definitely puts droids up there with them.
Thank you.
The cool thing I'm excited for is this does open up a new subset for Republic lists. Like, there's going to be some new, like, skews to where how Republic are going to play. You're going to be able to play a few different ways.
Mm-hmm.
This completely changes how just about every CIS list plays.
Because like Ben has been clamoring for, saving 120 points means quite a few more droids.
But
even taking a T-Series droid with one of the other commanders, I think is going to be super spooky to fix that, I have the turn where my bag is completely... Everything but General Grievous, everything but Dooku.
Sometimes Grievous is out of the, like, he's not in range.
Yeah.
Like, because I've had to rush Grievous up the middle to go take care of some things, and he's going to keep the army busy while my other droids are moving forward.
Yeah.
And so this gives me a great way of now starting that chain.
Because when Ben plays Grievous, there are no breaks.
No, there's really
he
not.
He is speed 2 towards the thing.
And there are no winners.
Twice.
There are no winners.
Speed 2, scale,
are you sure
get to the thing,
hide
behind the thing, destroy the thing.
I mean, because even if we want to ignore the commander, even if we want to ignore the cards, just the fact that you can get a 10 hit points on Grievous for 14 points, you can bring him up to 10, effective 10 wounds.
Right.
If you just have some B1s just kind of following him,
mm-hmm.
That's bananas land. It's so good.
Yep.
So good. And there's so many bodies to soak up the shots to get your heal guy, to keep him alive near him.
I have been frustrated by medics and things before not having access to anything like that. So it is cool to have the options now.
I mean, because I love Grievous's 2 pip, which allows everyone to have Guardian 2. I'll Guardian 2 and treat that man with that unit. Absolutely, I will. My life for you, Grievous. My life for you.
But with all this cool stuff, there was another. Forged in secrets. In the darkness. A card for one other faction. We have Vigilance.
Is it?
It is. So, maybe clones will take it too. I don't know.
Maybe.
I see this as a rebel card.
Maybe.
Hell yeah.
So let's talk about vigilance.
Yeah,
during the end phase, choose either one friendly trooper unit at range 1 to 2, baby. Or up to two friendly core trooper units at range 1 to 2. Each chosen unit does not remove a dodge token.
Nimble's worth something again.
What do you mean worth something again? It's always been cool.
It's always been worth something. It's always been worth something.
But there's not...
That's value getting town, man.
Getting tokens out is the tricky part in Rebels. I'm buying probably a set of each of these. I might buy a set of these for Will and a set of these for Ben and open the box, take Vigilance and the comm scanner out. Because this card's so cool.
I do like it for factions that not mine. But I mean, right. I do actually like it a lot.
I think this is for clones and rebels, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I've seen things around where it's vigilance
and a bunch of situational awareness clones, which I do not want to unleash on anyone I would call friend. because they would cease to be that. Will likes to
play
games
with people, and so...
This is going to take Rebel Troopers to another level. Leia with the 6-point scanner that lets her pass 3 dodge tokens now, and this camping out with a set of Rebel Troopers. I think it's gonna make Rebel Troopers come alive again, or even putting this on maybe something more mobile like a Jin and having her run around with a set of Mandos is gonna be so cool.
Now I'm excited to run 3 copies of this in one list.
Jesus.
Because I can run Obi-Wan, Rex, and Padme all with their command slots.
That is so gross.
And save
this
all so the dodges. Gross.
This is the card that finally makes sense on why Cassian does not have a command upgrade slot.
Oh, yeah. God forbid Cassian be okay.
Well, between him and letting them keep it on K2, you know, that makes some sense.
Well, yeah. No, well, I knew something had to be coming down the pipeline when Aiden didn't have a command upgrade and Cassian didn't. There's going to be something bonkers that's coming, and it's this card right here.
But once again, I have to ask, why does Padme the operative have a command slot?
I have no idea. I've been whining about Padme since day one.
Guys, Padme's bad. The internet says so.
y'all are just wrong. But that's
I don't get it either. Someone come tell us why.
Well, someone not on from Discord. The Legion Discord. I mean, we've read the guard chat, guys. Like it's time to get out of your house. It's time to get in the sunshine.
Don't go there.
It's a
hive of scum and villainy.
But yeah, this card is so cool. I'm super pumped for it. Tim, do you have any use for this card? Do you think?
Nope. Next.
Okay, I didn't think so.
Cool.
Didn't this feature in your bad token town list?
I can put it in my list to try and keep either Vader or my Dubax alive. Maybe that's about the only use I see for it.
But the thing is, it requires a non-spent dodge token,
I know.
So you don't have nimble.
Yep.
I'm with Tim. Like,
yeah. Let's turn the paradigm shift on its head here. What if instead of binoculars, we gave the portable scanner to Krennic and he stood next to his Death Troopers with Vigilance up?
That's a list.
That's the appropriate response, Tim.
I have a list saved where there are a whole bunch of portable scanners and some Vigilance out there. I don't think it's good, but it's something I have.
it's a thing you can do.
Because I wanted to, you should trust your instincts on that. I wanted to feel included, so I wanted to use Vigilance. So, you know.
This card for me is going to... I have not played Leia a whole lot lately, like in the past year.
Because she's still good.
She just gets outshined, but here's the thing. She's still good. How often have you used that double command?
I ran her with Improv and Esteemed, and that was all right. I mean, a lot of times I'll take
Improv, sometimes Strict. But this card, I just feel like you staple. You're just going to staple that right on Leia.
Oh, absolutely.
And she's, what, 101 points now with
this and a field scanner?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So 107 points or 106 points if you want to put an Improv or a Strict Orders on her.
Right.
Yeah, it's going to be... Leia's back on the menu. It's gross. I'm excited. I'm so excited for this card.
But sure. I think solo Leia's always been a thing lurking back there. You just are addicted to your character ball.
I think the other players who would play solo Leia, I think what they just tended to gravitate towards the generic commander and saving those couple points to be able to get more bulk on their Mandos or whatever it is that they're running or their Luke.
Right.
to fill that command role.
Yeah, I think we're all excited for these to come out, except for Tim.
Yeah, it's neat. Well, except for
Tim's clones will look forward to the clone upgrade.
Yeah, I guess. I guess might as well
give up.
No, you don't have to.
Yeah.
Go to the darker side. Go to the darker side.
No, Ben, stop it.
It's too late for me. It's fine.
That's.
Let me peel this mask off your face. We have made plenty of
jokes about playing the shuffle here at STABcast, where Tim's going to start playing clones, Will will start playing Rebels,
and I'll have
Ben's
got
to go back to his Imperials, and I'll have to go play CIS.
And then Ben will try to learn you why he's been complaining.
That's exactly it. I mean,
and I'll be like, no, this is, I embrace the chaos of AI. This is fun. I don't got to think as much.
I did wonder when Ben chose that faction.
Yep, we all did.
I've learned, and I will say I've learned to live with the dice, because white dice don't do anything.
You have no other choice.
It's quite delightful.
That's why you've learned to live with it.
That's what I've learned to live. There's no choice there. It forced me into it. I mean, yeah. But so we actually get to try all these things out, which is the nice part, in the Invader League.
Oh, yes.
Which just tonight announced up our brackets. Yes. So I haven't done all the Invaders.
This is Wednesday.
I've only done 2.5. It doesn't really matter. I've only done 2.5 Invader Leagues. One Invader League I got started, but then some school stuff happened, so I couldn't do that. And then I did this past summer, and I did one way on back. So this will be my third Invader League. So, gentlemen, I believe Will's playing, Tim's playing. Ryan's like, oh, I can't because of my schedule, blah, 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 blah. So what's the goals for this Invader League? We all played last time in the summer. So, Will, what's your goal this time?
Well, in light of my bracket being revealed to me.
You were supposed to type these out before, but sure, go ahead.
Before knowing about the brackets, I had hoped to do decent, and if it swung my way, I maybe could sneak in the second place slot to the single limbs.
So like a 3-2 with a strong strength schedule.
That's where I would hope to sit.
What a wonderful aspiration you have, sir.
Right. Yes.
All right. Will was going to play his clone degeneracy. We'll get there. It was going to be nothing but clone degeneracy to win, but
Ben, what about yourself, my friend? What's your goal for the season?
I had grand goals of, I mean, I made the single limb both times I played fully. Yeah, so true. I was like, I was going to probably make that depending on my bracket. So I was going to do well, I thought.
Yeah.
I thought, but then we saw some brackets. I mean,
hold. We're apparently holding.
I mean, yeah. Well, I mean,
if I have to circle the airport, you do too.
Yeah, evidently. Yeah, that's
circling,
fine.
Circling.
Mine was, I just want to make single limb so I can see the chat. That's it. Okay. That's it.
That's fair.
Yeah, we actually had more fun getting kicked out of the single elimination chat.
Oh, absolutely. 100%.
I want to be a part of that.
The gift was strong. So when you were in single limbs, if you lost your single elimination game, you were given like 30 seconds before Thrawn came in and kicked you out.
Yeah, like, it was a good time.
He posted a nice meme. You're like, oh no, and then gone.
The moment mine between was being voted off the island and getting thrown off the island.
Right.
Yes.
Like mine was like the Doctor Who, like, I don't want to go, and then boom, gone.
Yeah, so you could post your own GIF, and then it was responded to with another GIF. So much so that I got a couple people who were inside the single limbs to send me the gifts of people who were leaving, because I thought it was so funny.
Mr. Stark, I don't feel so good fades away.
Yeah. That was good.
Sorry, that was still traumatic for a lot of people.
As someone who's never made it to the single limbs, I wanted to cheat my way in.
Yes,
and working nights and weekends, Invader League's always been really tough for me. And in the time that we are living in, work has been incredibly busy. So I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna help judge. I'm not going to take up a play spot when it's a season I'm probably not going to be able to finish. And so I became a glutton for punishment, and I'm judging 4 groups.
Nice.
And I guess my goal for this is, A, I'll get to hang out in single limb chat, which will be fun, and no one can kick me out until it's over. Well, people can, but hopefully they won't.
Kick him out.
Yeah, and my goal is to – I want to get one of my 4 pods that I'm responsible for to be the first group done and complete.
Don't apply pressure to those poor men and boys.
That's right.
Well, anyway, I didn't think it was going to happen, and then I saw a couple of my groups who we may be done by Thursday. Who knows?
That's right. That's the spirit.
I mean, I will say this last one, Tim was done much faster. Like, he played 4 games before the rest of us. Because we actually tried to have, remember, we had that prediction contest with all the other podcasts.
It was a good time.
And they were Tim's already 4 games in. So
maybe one of our best episodes ever.
It was a good time.
It was one of our better episodes.
It was a good time.
So these are all grand plans. Right. And then we actually saw the brackets.
And we saw the brackets.
Yep.
So They labeled the brackets with people who had been to single eliminations before, people who had won the thing or been the top eight. So you could tell kind of the gameplay of your opponents as was known if they'd played before.
How screwed you really are.
How screwed you really are. So, Tim, your bracket, how screwed are you?
Oh, I'm super screwed. Like, like I thought I thought last season was rough. Oh, man. Oh, wow. Degree Ikentris, which I don't know them personally, but I've seen them play. I've seen videos of them play. They're very good. Acer, Basecore, Tomator, all of these names I know, and all these names I fear. So,
of the six, four have gone to single eliminations.
Yep.
Two of them have not, but I've seen them play as well, and they're really good.
And of those four that have gone before, one of them is Tim.
Well, yeah.
But still,
unfortunately.
But still.
We knew that happened.
Tim.
Yeah, so.
Can you get fifth in this group?
Maybe.
Maybe. As opposed to sixth in this group?
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Now, we say this, but remember, Tim beat Florf the Dwarf last time.
It's true.
And Magic.
Tim can pull crazy things out. Crazy Magic and Invader League. I'll give
both
him credit.
Both of them were very good. Yeah. But wait, yeah,
so much so that Florf the Dwarf was glad not to be paired up with Stabcast because he couldn't afford to lose to another Stabcast member.
Yeah.
Well.
Yep. No, he.
Like, what? Emotionally or physically, he would never recover.
Right.
He had hoped to not be paired with a Stabcaster. But then, half an hour after Tim's bracket is revealed, we get to mine. Because so many people play in this, and that's great. And we had all made fun of Tim because we were in a call together, and we were making fun of Tim for his bracket. And then mine appears.
Yep.
Yep.
Oh. And I'm in here with Mitrakin, Bobette,
yep,
NSB, Brad, and Florf the Dwarf.
Yeah. I think yours is worse than mine, even.
I think so, like, too. Thank you.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, sure is.
Which is no disrespect to people in my bracket. Like, they're very
Bobette
good.
Bobette beat the tar out of Will and myself last time.
Yeah, Bobette we played in the June League, and Mitrakin was our judge. So now I get to face all of these people who will likely show me the meaning of pain and suffering and all that.
Oh, I'm sure there's no memories of any past times. But if there is, that's okay. Punish him. Punish him for the memories.
Will, can you achieve fifth place in your group?
Yes.
That's bold, but okay. A confident yes. Okay, a confident yes.
Calling you out, like Brad. Coming for you.
Beat his ass.
I'm going to lose to Brad so hard now.
Brad, I need Brad to beat his ass.
Is that gift from...
Or I'll go I'll go 1-4 with my one win against Florf the Dwarf. We'll see.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe he just chokes when it comes to the stab cast.
That's how this will work.
Oh.
Bananas will be flying.
It's that scene from Kung Fu Hustle where he challenges a small kid in the crowd.
Yeah.
It turns out he's built like, you know, a body lifter.
Yep. Yeah, yeah. He stands up and's like, oh. Yeah, that's Brad. Exactly. Right.
That's Brad. That's Brad.
So I'll report back with my 0-5 finish on what I brought. All sorts of things like that.
Good luck on that. Good luck on
that. If only I had gotten a group with maybe less, you know, reputable players like some other people may have lucked into.
All right. So listen, my group consists of Sparkle Force, Jim Jam, Strutter, Rowdy Foyne, I think this will be fun as well, and Karma 5-5 and myself. Now, Karma 5-5 and myself have both gone to single limbs before, neither the other people, but with a name like that, I think I've got the best bracket.
Strutter's also something.
Strutter's good. Yeah.
Strutter's good.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. We've got a great bracket. With names like that, we are all about the fun in this bracket. We're going to have a fantastic Discord chat time. We're already sending gifts to each other. It's going to be a good day. It's going to be a 1980s disco. We're just going
to
rock it out.
It sounds like you need to change your name back to like Bowtie Pizzazz, and then you can get on this group's mood.
I probably should. We're going to have all sorts of fun.
You're the odd one out.
I really am, honestly.
That's true.
Because you got to put that Stabcast on things. But we'll Stabcast Ben Bowtie. Stabcast Bowtie. But yeah, I think, I don't know any of these names other than Strutter. I mean, so I think odds of me making better than fifth? Maybe.
Better than fifth. Okay.
Excellent.
So the problem is I'm playing droids. I'm playing new droids with new things.
Guys, get in with me on this. I'm very confident that you'll at least play second, Ben. I couldn't see you doing worse than that.
Not a chance.
Right, guys? Yeah. No, I think Ben's going to do great, and nothing bad will happen to him.
Just like I definitely wouldn't think to give a shirt to someone who, you know, guaranteed that they knocked him out of the single limbs. You know,
or a fanny pack.
Right. Well, who could say? Wow. Who could say what could happen?
I could only see Ben doing great in this.
How bizarre.
We're inciting the gods against me and also offering bribes for putting me down.
No one said that.
No one's done this. Whoa, allegedly.
Your exact words were, I would offer a t-shirt to a man who...
I said I wouldn't say.
As the judge of judges, I didn't hear anything.
It's fine.
Collusion.
So, you have no proof.
So those are people who are having much fun in this. So
this is what we do to each other.
I got four games, or four groups to monitor, to collect this from.
I have no games.
But I was thinking, you know, I'm going to get a bunch of people, you know, at all the conventions I've been at with LJ, you know, I'm always talking to new people and trying to get people into the game. And I'm like, I'm going to get a bunch of new people, or maybe like not the top brackets to lord over. And that did not happen. I think every one of my brackets has either a judge or one of the prominent streamers or a member of the production crew from the league in it. Starting with one group that's I have a lot of Civil Wars too, where we have Notorious Scoundrels, Orchimedes, and Dash and Zotac, who's also a judge, all in the same group. Group 12 is the one I don't know. Probably I know the least amount of people in. But my good buddy from Warfare Weekend, we shared many bourbons together. I shot many e-webs. Is playing in my group, so that should be fun. And then we've got the Garn and Nerfly Civil War in group 23, and then I got Endless in 24. So it's gonna be a really fun set of groups to full of lots of personality to preside over, and I have no idea how to call these groups. They all look pretty competitive and a little top heavy. So I was thinking, like, maybe after the bracket reveal, I can make some best guesses on how I think things are going to go down. Nope, no idea. All four of these groups are going to be bloodblasts, and they're going to be a lot of fun to hang out in, and throw some memes around and collect lists. So it'll be fun.
That is your job.
Last time we were talking about which the group of death, the one that's going to be hardest to get out of. And, there were a couple in season 5, but this season,
There's a few.
There's several. Yeah,
there's a lot of them. I mean, the fact that Will and Tim are playing in one of them, and you've got four really rough groups. I say rough, like they are really high-powered, lots of great players.
Hard to call.
I mean, lots of great players. I'm just saying, if you haven't had the chance to really watch a stream, you really got to go pay attention to these. You're going to see some great games on some great maps with some interesting design ideas. Now, maybe your hosts who are streaming aren't quite so fun. You should probably listen to Timitation Irish, you know.
Yeah.
Co-stream you should probably be doing. Because, you know us, we have lots of fun while streaming, fully admitting we know nothing about how this game
works. Exactly,
yeah. Once Tim and I go 1-4 or 0-5, we're going to stream together all these good players.
All the time.
Oh, yeah.
But there's going to be some excellent Legion play in this Invader League. I mean, excellent play to be watched.
I'm super excited. You know, I'm not getting to play, but I am. It almost feels like I also am baited with anticipation to see how all this is going to go down. I'm pumped.
Exciting times for Legion.
Yes.
And nary a mention of Tauntauns.
Nary a mention of Tauntauns.
Because but we did staps have to say worse.
The
word
nary. Yeah, staps are the new Tauntauns, everybody.
Yep.
So I will say one person here, though, and I didn't realize it till a few minutes ago. One person did get the absolute worst draw out of everyone in this whole tournament.
Who might that be?
It's Garn.
Oh.
Because Garn obviously has to play with his Team Relentless teammate, Nerfly, in my group that I'm in charge of, God help us all. In the two groups that he is overseeing, Ben, who's your judge?
It's Garn.
Brett's not here, but Brett is in Garn's other group, so he's got stab casts in all three groups that he gets to be a part of. I'm sorry.
Hi.
That truly is the worst thing I could imagine.
That's he just always true. What a horrible fate.
Well, as always, when we subject ourselves to more and more people among the Discord, I guess you could end our show.
It's time to leave.
It's time for us to go, since we will be there waiting in the darkness.
Right. Much like a virus.
Thanks for the... Whoa, okay.
Oh,
thanks for listening to the STABcast.
Is that the where like we draw always, the line
we appreciate
now?
You.
Is that it?
I'm ignoring Tim. Tim's That's shouting at me. I'm talking through him. Thank you for listening, however you do it. We love you. Until next time, I'm Will Heim reminding you, droids delenda est.
I'm Ryan Slowski reminding you to tip your judges. It's not bribery, I promise.
We're going to need that in the rules packet.
Yeah, wait... I'm Tim Hannon, reminding you, Clone Wars factions delenda est.
And I'm Ben Fowler, reminding you, perhaps we can build a second throne to sit next to the clone one.
Oh, now you call for unity, huh?
It's a Roger throne. A Roger Roger throne.
Clones must be destroyed until we're also good.
We'll destroy them on the field of battle, and they should also be destroyed. So
you could have faced my clones, but you chickened out because of a headache.
Good night, everybody.
Good night. Good night.
Droids have are the night, headache. Everybody.
They are.
Welcome, cadets and commanders, to the STABcast, the Sons for Your Technical Attack Brigade Star Wars Legion podcast. Why are you already laughing?
What?
I didn't even get to the intro.
Just giggling. Listen, you just Will, ignore Will. You can mute. Will can mute himself out. You just keep going.
Sorry, I react
now
to my co-host.
Which you shouldn't have, Tim.
Just because I don't react to your bullshit doesn't mean that's how I react to people. All right.
I'd like to apologize to everyone.
Trying it again.
Except Tim.
Counting us in.
All right. In 3, 2, 1.
Wait.
Really? Just me, huh? Just me.
You don't count us in, sir.
Oh,
you've never counted us in.
Oh, is that against
it's
the
my
law?
Goddamn job.
No, I'm sorry.
Tim, I'm sorry. Is your name Ben Fowler? It is
as
Ben
long
Fowler
as we're fact, all so. Still rolling and haven't stopped. Just take a breath, Tim, and do your. All intro.
Right, that's fine. That's correct. What I was going to. That's stopped. What I was trying to do. All right.